Yesterday, on August 12, 2024, at 12:20 local time, a sharp jolt shook the Los Angeles metropolitan area, including Hollywood, causing the ground to shake for around 12 seconds. The earthquake in question only registered in as a magnitude 4.4, but still managed to cause a minor level of damage, causing an elevator to stop and a pipe to break in Pasadena Hall, and for dozens of people to report that glass picture frames they had hanging on the wall had shattered. The aforementioned damage, where the earthquake was its most intense, in my opinion, would best fit the category of MMI-5 shaking, aka a moderate intensity. Before I discuss why this earthquake occurred, let me address a more immediate worry some people might have: aftershocks. Aftershocks almost always follow larger magnitude earthquakes following a nice 1 over x rate, with x starting at a value of 1 and increasing as the unit of time increases. So, are there any chances that a truly damaging earthquake could occur specifically in the next week in the vicinity of Los Angeles? Yes, but the odds are incredibly low. How low? About 1 in 2,000, which marks the estimated chance that a magnitude 6.0 or larger earthquake strikes, whereas an even lower risk of a magnitude 7.0 or larger earthquake exists, being about 1 in 20,000. As for a smaller magnitude 5 range earthquake, which could still cause some more limited damage, the odds of that in the next week are about 1 in 200. In other words, only small aftershocks are expected, with a 1 in 20 chance of a magnitude 4 aftershock occurring, and a 1 in 3 chance of at least one magnitude 3 aftershock occurring. This means that Los Angeles residents, due to the nature of the earthquake, may strangely not end up feeling any aftershocks at all, or you may feel a few very weak ones. While various news sources were quickly to point out that, yes, Monday's earthquake did occur on the same fault system that generated the deadly and highly damaging magnitude 5.9 Whittier Narrows earthquake, I want to remind everyone that this does not mean that a similar event is even remotely likely anytime soon. Instead, the 4.4 magnitude earthquake represented an event which on average strikes the Los Angeles area about once every 26 months, with the vast majority of these quakes occurring on thrust faults. Thrust faults are essentially reverse faults, where the hanging wall moves up relative to the foot wall, except that the fault plane occurs at an angle of 45 degrees or less. These faults occur in areas undergoing compression, and Los Angeles is no exception to this, as the area between the Palos Verdes Hills and the San Gabriel Mountains are being squeezed closer and closer together at a rate of 0.2 inches a year. That may not sound like a lot, but across 15,000 years, that compression adds up, totaling around 250 feet of compression. This is why this very region in that same time span has produced 11 magnitude 7.0 to 7.5 earthquakes, along with a range of smaller earthquakes such as what we all just witnessed, and earthquakes between these two magnitudes such as the highly destructive magnitude 6.7 North Ridge earthquake in 1994. These largely occur on northwest-southeast trending faults. By scanning the U.S. Geological Survey database, I determined that in the greater Los Angeles metropolitan area, not including the San Andreas Fault, a total of 30 magnitude 5 quakes and 6 magnitude 6 quakes have struck the area since 1769. This indicates an average rate of these earthquakes of once every 7 years, 1 month for a minimum magnitude 5 quake, and once every 42.5 years for a minimum magnitude 6 quake to strike the region. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.